welcome to the Lizzie, Gary, Bibi, and Trish Care promo show, hashtag LGBTQue. I'm your host, Jezebel Montero, the writer, director, producer, and actor of our podcast comedy series by the same name, Lizzie, Gary, Bibi, and Trish Care, episode 1. Every week this summer, we bring you one of the brilliant artists from our podcast series, so please subscribe to our YouTube channel right here, the Flock at the Films channel, or wherever you get your podcast, you can subscribe to the podcast. So listen to that first episode. I'm telling you, and you're going to want to hear more episodes. This is a one-of-a-kind show, guys. Seriously, there's nothing else like it. I'm not selling you, but I defy you to not only find a situation comedy podcast, but also one like this. Multi-ethnic, LGBT, female-centric, Latino-twisted. Boom. It doesn't exist. Except for now. So, if you want more content like this, you have to support it, okay? So, now for the exciting part. We have a really, really amazing actress and performer and voiceover artist. I mean, I was so lucky to find her in Miami, where most Cubans reside, the second Havana. She was a complete find. I didn't know her at all. And we met during quarantine, during this recording of this show, of the comedy series, and she just nailed it. Here is Barbara Alvarez. Hey, welcome to the show.
Hi. It's so good to be here.
I know. It's good to see you. I mean, this is kind of like the first time we've ever seen each other, right?
I know.
Oh my God, this is incredible. I basically met you on the phone, because this is how we do it with voiceover artists, on the phone, email, during the casting of Lizzie, Gary, Bibi, and Trish Care, right?
Right. We didn't even see each other. This is the first time we're seeing each other. Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about who you are and how you became an actor and
an artist. I am Cuban. I wasn't born in Miami. I came over on the first boat lift, Camarioca.
Did you really?
Yep. I got here when I was a year old. And my parents kind of moved around all over the place. I ended up in New York City at 30 years old thinking, I want to be on TV.
And so you were in my neck of the woods.
Yeah, exactly. And I just put up a notice on notebook paper at NYU. And I wanted to make a little film. And I thought, it'll be a demo reel. And some students followed me around the village. And we made a little demo reel. And I sent it to MTV. And I got called up. And I bombed the audition. But I was hooked after that. Long story short, 3 years later, 3 years of pounding the pavement, taking acting classes, you know, doing New York, I finally got a show on the Discovery Channel, a travel show called Travelers. And I did that for a few years, traveled the world, just exploring festivals all over the world. And
only 3 years in?
I felt like a lot to me.
No, that's the definition of overnight. Overnight success. Yes.
Okay.
That's the very definition.
And then I just went on to do, another show for Discovery, a food show. And I went on to do Home and Garden television. And I was on CBS for a little while as a contributor on the morning show. And then I had a child and I decided, you know what? I'm going to focus on being a mom.
Congratulations, by the way.
And so I left that world. But when he was about 15, now at this point, I'm in Miami and I'm a yoga teacher and I teach meditation and this, that, the other. I started thinking, I think I want to jump back in. So, and then I found you through backstage, and this is my comedic debut. It's the first time I'm actually letting myself do some fun, like, you know.
But how is that possible? You're so funny. How is this your comedic debut?
Thank you. And I'm going to take that compliment, girl.
I
come from a family where, you know, humor is a way to take the edge off of all the stuff that happens in life.
Sure,
and so it's a funny atmosphere. And so, yeah. And that's how Cecilia, my character, was born. You know, it's funny when I read your, the backstage, you know, sides and whatnot, I thought, I know this old woman. It's my mother, my aunt. These people are Cecilia. And that's who I based the character on.
I know. Oh, that's great. No, it came out great. And people, you have to listen to her because she says it's her comedic debut. But to me, she's a pro. You know, you're perfect. You also got the humor and the rhythm and you fit right in. I mean, you sound like Pancho's wife, don't you? You totally sound like Pancho's wife.
Thank you. It was great fun doing that character.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. This food show that you did, the Epicurious food show on the Discovery Channel, you know, mm-hmm. I know it.
I was a co-host for 3 years with Michael LaMonaco, the executive chef of Windows on the World.
That's the show you got in New York?
That was in New York.
And mm-hmm. how did you end up in Miami?
How did I end up coming back to Miami?
Coming back.
Family's here. And since I had a child, you know, I wanted him to have access to his grandparents and his cousins and aunts and uncles. And I felt like, yeah, I wanted to give that to him.
I think that's great. And plus, Miami's beautiful. And they do a lot of stuff. They do a lot of food shows, a lot of magazine shows. A lot of stuff goes on in Miami and more now than ever.
Yes.
You hosted 2 PBS concerts and fundraisers, Celtic Women or Celtic Woman?
That one was Celtic Woman and Under the Street Lamp, which is a Broadway show tunes. I host them all the time. And they're, you know, fundraisers for the community. And
that's,
you know,
fantastic.
Raise funds and for PBS and whatnot.
You shoot that in Miami too?
I shoot that in Miami, yes.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's fantastic. And you've got like tons of commercials. And I'm assuming you do a lot of voiceover stuff too.
I do a lot of voiceover stuff as well.
This is a good segue to go into our show, Lizzie, Gary, Bibi, and Trish Gay. You found it on Backstage and you applied. And from my perspective, we did have a lot of people. We had a lot of applications. It was quarantine. Nobody was doing anything. You know, it was April. I was doing the casting in April. Me and my producer, sound designer, were like, who is this woman? And I'm like, you're not going to believe she's young. She's playing like 60s or 70s, but you're actually younger than that. And but you nailed it. The vocal quality, everything. Tell me about your experience, you know, recording it, how you felt. Did you like the character when you first read the script? You know, any thoughts you had on the character and working with somebody you didn't even know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is all very interesting to talk about and to think about, because right around the time that I saw you on Backstage, I was doing Artist Way. And one of the things that surfaced for me is I want to start doing characters that are based on my heritage. And I started writing. And all of a sudden I see your ad and I see this character and I'm like, wow, that's serendipity, right? Like synchronicity, they call it in the book.
Yes.
And I reached out to you and, you know, you liked my audition and, you know, universe was like,
put us together. Because you put it out there.
What a cool experience. When I read it, I just saw my mom. I saw my aunts. I saw that, you know, crotchety old Cuban woman who is very good natured and loving. And at the same time, you know, isn't going to put up with anything from anyone. This character is in my blood. Really well written too. It was very fun.
Oh, thank you.
Great job.
Thank you. I think the parents are in a couple of more episodes and, you know, we're hoping to raise more money to shoot because it wasn't easy. We have a Grammy and award winning sound designer and music composer. It's, you know, we had people from all over the country. It was a SAG project. So it costs a lot of money to make these things. So we are looking to raise money, but we want to finish the season. I have 10 episodes. How do you feel about the way you were put into this group when you first record? There's nothing. You know, people don't realize, people out there, there's nothing. You have nothing to bounce off of. It's not mm-hmm. theater. It's not film. It's a completely different art form, right? Mm-hmm. You need to just imagine everything. So how did you feel when you first heard it?
Well, I have to say, Jezebel, I ran on faith with this whole thing. Because when I read it and you told me what we were going to do and podcast, and I'm thinking, how is this going to work? I mean, I was really like, I have no idea. And you said, don't worry about it. We're going to make it. Oh, it's going to be great. We're going to make it work. And I'm like, okay, I'm just going to do what I do and just trust. Because I was isolated in a little closet area in my back room. And I had you on the phone telling me, okay, give me another take and make it sound like this. All right, that was good. Now give me another take with a little bit more energy. And, you know, that coaching, that, you know, blow by blow. And
we worked well together.
Yes, we worked really well together. And then I just let go. And then when I heard it, it just came together so beautifully. It's incredible how you guys created this universe, this sound universe that conveyed, that told this story that you wanted to tell. And it's like, I kudos to you for doing this. I mean, this was beyond my imagination.
Oh my God. Thanks. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Barbara. Well, everything about a podcast and radio, like a radio play, right? Everything about that is really about, I know the writing is important, of course, but really it's, the acting is so important. I mean, it's everything, because the acting, also the vocal quality, the intonations, that creates that mood. And what's happening, there's no visual. So basically the sound design, you know, and the actors is what makes it. And I was very proud of everybody and very happy with the quality. So we're going to hope to keep going. I want to know what you're doing next, what you're up to, where can we listen to you and see you? And then we have to get out of here.
Okay, very good. So right now, one of my recent projects is I did a virtual exhibition for the Wolfsonian on deco design. And I'm really proud of that. It's a complete opposite from what I did with you and this character. It's more of a, you know, touring this these beautiful exhibits. And that will be available online soon.
Thank you so much for being part of this promo show and being part of our podcast. We will definitely work together again. I mean, if I have anything to say about it. But thank you so much for being here with us, giving us your time, your talent. I wish you the best of luck, and we'll see each other soon. Oh, we'll hear each other soon.
We'll hear each other soon. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Bye-bye. Bye. Take care. That was Barbara Alvarez. She plays Cecilia in our podcast comedy series, available on YouTube, Apple Podcasts, Podbean, everywhere, wherever you get your podcasts. Don't miss out on our weekly promo show. Every week we are promoting a different artist from the show, and it's really, really exciting. Next week, we have David DeVino. He plays two characters in our podcast, so don't miss that. You're not even going to recognize him. Two completely different voices. He's an amazing voiceover artist. He can do anything. So make sure you come and listen, join us, be with us. I'm Jezebel Montero, the writer, producer, director, and actor in Lizzie, Gary, Vivi, and Trish. Okay? Go listen to the episode. Adios.